H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Okay, so I'm just saying that in this particular text, I'm just validating whether this particular text is there or not. So contains this one. Okay, if it is there, I'll say that expected destination is displayed in the portal search results page. Said as we have our onliner statement, we don't need to write this. So this is the this is one of the validation. So here as per test case, I'm done with this. Now list of hotel names. How many hotel? Here it's like we have to find the in this page. We have to see how many hotels with the two star. This one. Now this is a bit difficult. We'll see. Here I don't find any unique property for a this 2-star and 3-star. Remember, so at division this contains are simply saying that here there is a LO and LO. So now it is I'm just thinking how we can recover this. So we have to find the elements. Any idea for anyone? How to find, how to see whether it is two star here? It is just we have reference. Here it will be, the structure will be like this. We will have two yellows here. Okay, the remains will be like white. Okay, the structure is like this. Now actually we have to find this. Okay, hotel name, description, container.
Kumar?
Yes.
One just guess, this is only the guess, like using, we can use the XPath and give contains hotel star rating LO, then we can use it with find by elements, right? Is that possible? No, I'm just guessing.
Contains of? In
class?
In XPath, yes, you mean find elements?
Yeah, find elements and.
No, what it will do, it is going to find the all the stars. Say here, here also we have.
No, we are checking the contains or the text with LO. Whatever LO is there, that we need to retrieve and.
Yeah, that's correct. What I'm saying here, one more, let me show what I'm saying. Now, if you observe here also, they go on. Here also it is showing yellow, yellow, and yellow. Three times yellow here. Whereas for this one, for this locator, it is saying two times yellow. If you use that logic, basically it is going to retrieve all the yellows in this page. Are you getting here? Basically, we need to have a collection like here. For this object, it has to say 4. For this object, it has to say 4. And for this level, it has to say 4. Like that, we have to retrieve. Yes, by using find elements and by using XPath, by saying that yellow contains of yellow, yes, it is going to retrieve. But it is going to retrieve all this, like say, if we, collection of, say, in this page, if we have 100 yellow star marks, it will say 100 yellows. But we need to have a collection based on the result level. Okay. Yeah.
But yeah, still again, one more step, like it's a row, right? Or TR, right? It's row or some columns based on that ID, we can get it right for each.
Yeah, yeah. That is what actually I'm thinking. Yes, I thought it's a row, but it's not actually a row. It seems to be like for us, for the viewable purpose, it is a row, but if you observe here, it is a division. Yep. I'm just thinking about the same thing. Yep. Probably we have to use this total. Can you see here? If you observe here, it is not a row, but it's a division. And this, I'm just looking into that only. Yep. See here, if you look at this, actually, when we the look and feel is like a row, but it's basically this one, hotel description outer container. See here, it's a kind of list, li list. So here in this list,
or another
yes, yep, probably no. Here, see here, by using this hotel rating, we'll try to get the collection of hotel ratings. So here it is going to give the collection of all these hotel ratings in this page, and after this hotel ratings, based on this hotel ratings, we will try to find this LS. I think it's here we need to write a double XPath. One XPath is for the hotel rating. I mean, we'll write a collection of hotel rating. It is going to retrieve all the hotel ratings over here. And from that object, from that hotel ratings object, we'll try to find this, this, like, as you said, contains of this hello. We'll try like this. What about others? Are you able to follow here? And I'm saying, we probably here, we have to write two XPaths. One XPath is for the finding the collection of this, collection of this ratings here. Okay. First of all, it will just get this particular object, this particular span, this particular hotel rating, this particular object from this application. And once we get this collection, probably we'll find this this here. We'll give a try over here. So let me take this hotel rating, and now let me go here. Now here object info. Here let me say public string static string and UI hotel result string underscore hotel rating. Now I'm making use of this. Now here, O browser, find elements. So I'm using find elements. Here I'm using find elements, and by dot ID. And here UI the dot this object. So basically by using the statement, it is going to give the a list of the objects. See here, every observer, when I say find elements, now everyone over here, this find elements, here if you see here list web element, okay, it means this highlighted line is going to, this highlighted line is going to give the list of web elements. Harita, you were asking one of the collection framework, right? Yep, see here, this is a part of the collection framework. If you remember, we already discussed this kind of concept, but I did not say this is a part of collection. Our intention was, as I said, it's a like practically oriented. I did not explain the theory part of Java. Okay, see here. This is part. This is one of the thing in collection object. So here mainly we use a collection list and set as part of collection framework. Okay, you were asking about collection framework, right? As part of Selenium, we use the list and the set. Set we have used somewhere. I think we have used that set. Using the while finding out the number of browsers in the application. Okay. Yeah, let me see. UI hotel ratings. I'm saying UI hotel ratings, and this is a collection object which is going to contain the collection of all these objects. Yep. Any basis why here I'm mentioning web element? Why here I have mentioned as web element? Any guesses? List represents the collection, and here web element. It means list of web elements. What is the meaning of web element here in Selenium? Yep. If you remember, I said here in Selenium, each and every object, the object over here will be treated as a web element. Okay, it might be a button, it might be a say a text, it might be a checkbox, anything in terms of Selenium terminology. Yes, it is a kind of data type, web element. Okay, that's correct. So this object now it contains the collection of all these hotel ratings. Okay, now it will contain the collection of all these hotel ratings. Now see here, now I am going to write a for loop. Now let me say UI hotel ratings. Now let me say UI hotel H rating. I am saying H rating. I have to write like this. Okay, so here basically this for loop is going to be iterated based on this. Okay, this UI rating. Each time, for each iteration, this is going to represent each web element here. Okay, this collection. Okay, now based on this, actually here, if you clearly observe here, if you all observe here, 4 out of 5, 3.5 out of 5, can you observe here the numbers? Probably we can, we can see wherever we did not get the numbers. Here it is saying 2.5. I think for all these things, but for this it is not getting up. Can you all agree here? I think we can even we can take this as a reference. This one. Can you agree here? Yep. Here if you agree here the name, it has 4.5. Probably we can take this as the reference also. We can retrieve the objects. I think Devon, we have done this in QTP like this only, right? Yep, see here. So we can we can take this as the reference and we can work out it. But we'll go ahead with the same one whatever we have discussed now. it seems to be kind of a bit challenging. Now see here. Now again, I'm using find element here. Now you, everyone close your grab. Each iteration, it represents this object. And from this object, from this particular object, each time it is going to represent. For in each iteration in this for loop, it is going to represent this one. In this object, we will try to export again. We're saying that we want to find this number of this one. Okay. Now see here, let me complete this. Here, let me say find element. Oh, we already write find element. So here find, I'm saying export, and here as of now, let me hard code here. Here export will be like this. Under this particular object, we wanted to find this one, right? So say this contains. What is the HTML tag? What is the HTML tag of the object? Span. And here I'm taking a property here. Let me say contains. Contains, and the property is class. Okay, and it contains this rating hello. Part of this is, I can simply say hello. Whatever the span which contains hello, I want to retrieve that. Okay, let me say find, we'll see. Yep, if you observe when I say find, basically it's not throwing an error. At the same time, it is not highlighting. Basically, all this generally it represents all the star marks. Probably we will use this. We'll see it will work or not. Now let me keep this export here. So we have a portal rating, and where we have kept this, star related we did not kept anywhere. Okay, here it is, seems to be star rating. Okay, we already used this. Okay. Now see, let me keep over here, and let me say this is a export. Okay, now let me take this. Let me save this also. Okay, so now again it is going to give the collection of again objects. Now see here, it will say again list web element, and here the collection is UI star rating, number of star ratings, or no, it represents the star rating. One minute, something went wrong here. Find element.
Elements.
Yes, here we have to use find elements, yes. And here yeah, that's correct. Now it is going to give the list of this one. Now see here, it has a method saying that size. Okay, size means it is going to give the number of values, number of elements that it has captured. Now what we need, now see here, let me say, let me capture this number, int number of what do I say, stars, number of stars. So basically this is going to give the number of stars. And is this logic is correct one? Can I mention like this? Okay. Basically, it is not preferable to mention, it is not preferable to declare a variable within the loops. For the first iteration, it will work. For the next iteration, it will throw an error saying that this declaration, this variable is already declared. Okay. Are you able to understand here? You have to keep it outside of the for loop. Declaration part you have to keep outside the for loop. And you have to use like this. Don't mention directly. Don't declare the variables in the, within the loops. Okay. Now this variable contains the number of elements in that particular stars. Okay. Now here what we say is this number of stars. What is our logic? What we need actually? How many hotels have less than 3 stars? And okay, we want less than 3. So we'll say simply less than 3 here. Okay. So here, list of the hotels name and here basically we want the name of it. Okay, name of the hotel and then. It seems fine, found. Fine, name, we will just take the name here. See here, less than 3 means in that case we have to get the name of the hotel here. Okay. So, name of the hotel means again we have to go to the parent of this. See here, we are actually getting this hotel rate, right? So, if you want the name, where we can find this. Okay, here. The hotel name is here. Yep, see here, hotel name. Now see here, I'm trying to establish the connection between hotel rating and the hotel name. Okay, hotel rating is here and whereas the hotel name is here. Okay, however, so this is one division. So the sibling division is this. Preceding sibling, right? We as part of expert we have discussed the preceding sibling, but basically we have to take this and we have to go here. We have to find its based on this hotel rating, we have to find its parent. Okay, from its parent we have to find the preceding sibling. Are you able to follow this XPath? Sure. We are able to find the hotel rating. From that hotel rating basically we have to go to the two parents following ancestor. Okay, after that we have to go to the this one. What else we can use over here then instead of this? Are able to follow what I am saying? Here we are able to find the hotel rating. From that actually I am finding this name. One other thing is by using XPath, here basically it's going to be a complex XPath. We have to go to the parent like that. So here is the object. So we have to go here. We have to go here. Okay, let me do one thing. Let me try like this. Let me give a try here in Selenium IDE. First of all, that complex export is going to work here or not. First span at the rate ID auto rating. Let me say fine. It is identifying this one. It is identifying the first one. Okay, because here we have so many hotel ratings, so by default it is taking the first one here. Okay. Now, based on this, what I'm saying here, first of all, we'll find its ancestor. Or I think I can directly say ancestor is this. What was that? I think you have to use like this, right? Ancestor. Let me say fine. And you have to say ancestor type. Div. Let me refer the export. It's been long time, even I use this. Okay, slash ancestor. See here. We have to use slash ancestor. It is highlighting, you know, entire table. If you observe here, you can find a kind of, you know, green color bar here for the entire table. It's highlighting something else. Division. Let me say. Let me try to give this directly. Division at the red ID. Not ID, sorry. Class. Let me go slowly. We'll try to find this. Ancestor, and whose division is this? Right. But when I simply say div, it is highlighting the complete one. Class. Can you observe here? By using this, first of all, I'm trying to identify this. Okay. So after this, I want to identify this one. Okay. Which will be sibling? Which will be preceding sibling? This will be preceding sibling, and whose type is div. Let me say fine. Can you observe now? It is highlighting that particular hotel name. Okay, and probably by using this, I can simply say get text, I can print it. Or what we can say here, from the sibling. Okay, from the sibling, I mean basically it is highlighting the preceding sibling, means it is getting this one from the sibling. Basically, where is this hotel name? Here is the hotel name. Okay, we can simply say here's here division. Here we can say span whose class is this one, hotel name. Can you close up with that? It is just highlighting this hotel name. Okay. Now this logic has to be used. This logic has to be used in all these this for loop, because we basically we want to return that name of the hotel and that name of the hotel, right? So here UI H rating dot find element, and here again by XPath. And let me create one more variable here saying that public static string UI hotel screen result screen underscore portal name. It's a big X path. Let me see if we have hard coded anything. Portal name, it should be there. This container should be there. And here portal rating is not required because it will be, this is represented by our one of the object, right? In that case, how it is going to recognize them? It has to start its ancestor. Find elements. Okay. Let's see. We'll observe. We'll mention like this. Okay. We'll see whether it is going to recognize or not. And here this is the X path. I hope everyone has understood that complex, that X path. Now this is basically going to retrieve the name of the hotel. Okay. So again, let me declare the variable outside string. Yes, hotel name. Okay. Okay. Here we have to use get text, right? We have to retrieve the text. Okay, so this hotel name will get into this name, and here we have to write a logic to save into the notepad. You know about it, right? How to save in your notepad? Do you want me to write it? Again, we have to create the file object. File. Hotel name. New. File. And here we have to give the path of the file name where we want to create the this one. Here, as of now, let me mention here. I'm mentioning this location. Let me see. Hotel names dot txt. I'm doing something wrong here. Let me refer to again the previous one. Now we are also doing the same thing, right? File, we are giving the object. Why it is restricting us? Am I doing anything wrong over here? Any guesses? Let me do one thing. Let me copy this line. Okay, got it. I think probably the imported the file method, I think I did not import the correct one. Here it has been imported something in JXL. It is imported from the JXL. Yep, here while importing this file, I think I was imported from this JXL. You have to import this java.io. Okay. Then here you have to have a print writer. Let me say OPW and new print writer, and here we have to pass the show hotel names. Okay, and then here in this OPW, right, and we are going to write this particular hotel name. Okay, and then at the end of this, we are going to close this OPW dot flush for the saving, and OPW for the this one close. Okay, so we are going to write, and we are going to we are entering, and we are saving, and we are closing. Okay, so this is for the this one, hotel name. And even if you want to find the like number of hotels, what you can do here, you can have a flag. Okay, say let me have let me say integer, let me say I count, let me start with 0, and here see, this is the I count, and whenever it comes to this less than 3, I will increase this variable. Okay, I am incrementing this value. Okay, it just counts. And before I know here, finally what I will do here, OPW, I will say that, write, and here I am going to write saying that number of hotels less than 3 rating will be or like this. Okay, here I am going to mention this I count here. Okay, so finally before it saves and before it closes the file, it basically prints the number of hotels. So this count will increase. So if you have 5, it is going to increase, it is going to be 5. Okay, now let me remove this variable. Yep. You can see some more errors here. Where are here? Now basically it is a throws exception error. Here. Let me say add throws declaration. Yep, fine.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.